Bonjour
et bienvenue.
Comme vous le voyez, nous sommes dehors. Nous venons de finir une séance. On espère que ça va vous plaire.
Dites-le nous dans les commentaires. Pensez à vous abonner.
C'est super important. Bonne vidéo, crâne.
Merci.
True or false? Nudity is never allowed on YouTube. What do you think? The answer is false. While sexually explicit content like pornography isn't allowed, we actually allow nudity when the primary purpose is educational, documentary, scientific, or artistic. And if there's no nudity, but minimal clothing meant only to be sexually provocative, it'll likely be age-restricted. Let's take a look at other examples. A creator uploads a video about the greatest works of art in history, which contains nude artwork. In another video, a creator uploads a compilation of hacked photos and clips that contain nude celebrities. Do either of these videos violate our community guidelines? Yes. The second video violates the sex and nudity policy because the content and purpose of the video is meant to be sexually gratifying. Of course, there are gray areas and lots more to our policy around sex and nudity on YouTube. How much of it do you understand? For example, What if you just made a playlist of clips of celebrity wardrobe accidents? Could your channel get a strike? To learn the answer and more, go to the YouTube Help Center article on sex and nudity. Click here or the link in the description. Thanks for watching. True or false? Making a video where your friend appears to choke you and you challenge others to try it is okay as long as no one gets hurt in your video. The answer is false. Content that encourages illegal or dangerous activities is not allowed on YouTube. Neither is content that risks serious physical harm or death. A video that depicts illegal or dangerous acts may be allowed if the primary purpose is educational, documentary, scientific, or artistic, and it isn't gratuitously graphic. For example, a news piece on the dangers of choking games would be appropriate, but posting clips out of context with the intent to shock viewers might not be. Let's take a look at another example. A creator uploads a video about how to make a rocket using baking soda, vinegar, and an empty bottle. They encourage viewers to try the scientific experiment with adult supervision. In another video, a creator shows how to make Molotov cocktails and encourages people to use them for riots. Do either of these videos violate our community guidelines? Yes, the second video violates the harmful dangerous policy. YouTube does not allow instructional bomb or explosive making when the main purpose of the produced item is to cause serious injury. But what about prank and challenge videos? When do those violate YouTube's community guidelines? To learn that and more about our policies around harmful or dangerous content, go to the YouTube Help Center article linked here or use the link in the description. Thanks for watching. True or false? Footage, audio, or imagery featuring natural disaster aftermath or medical procedures are never allowed on YouTube. The answer is false. If enough context is provided along with violent or gory content, we may apply an age restriction rather than remove the video completely. However, violent or gory content intended only to shock or disgust viewers, or content encouraging others to commit violent acts, is not allowed on YouTube. Let's take a look at some examples. A creator uploads a compilation video of car accident clips that feature violent and gory images. In another video, a creator uploads live footage of professional boxers in an arena with referees and an audience. Do either of these videos violate our community guidelines? Yes, the first video violates our violence policy because it does not provide proper context for the clips. Remember, if you believe anyone is in imminent danger, you should reach out to your local law enforcement to report the situation immediately. But what about uploading violent imagery or audio that has been blurred, masked, or obscured? Is that okay? For a list of what we consider when determining whether to age restrict or remove content, and to learn more about our policies around violent content, go to the YouTube Help Center article. Click here or the link in the description. Thanks for watching. True or false? If you fill a video's title, description, or tags with terms or names, such as the names of celebrities, that are unrelated to the video, that could result in the video being removed. The answer is true. Spam, scams, and other deceptive practices that take advantage of the YouTube community aren't allowed on YouTube. Let's take a look at a few examples. A creator uploads a video with a thumbnail showing celebrities from a popular late-night TV show. The video does not contain the late-night clip and instead is a screen directing viewers to another website. In another video, a comedian uploads their latest comedy routine. At the end of the video, the creator encourages fans to check out their comedy website, which is linked in the description. Do either of these videos violate our community guidelines? Yes, the first video violates our spam policy. Be sure to only share links when they're relevant to the video, add value to viewers, and don't trick people into visiting other websites. But what about posting the same comment multiple times? Would that be okay? To learn that and more, go to the YouTube Help Center article on spam, scams, and deceptive practices. Click here or the link in the description. Thanks for watching.
We want to ensure creators and viewers have the tools and information they need to feel safe while on YouTube. And though the majority of YouTube's creators and viewers use YouTube to share, learn, and connect, we know there are instances of harassment and even sometimes displays of hate that are difficult for users and creators to see and experience. In this video, we'll walk you through some of the policies, tools, and features in place to help you feel safe on YouTube. To start, let's talk a bit about YouTube's specific policies that help protect against hate and harassment. First, our hate speech policy. Content is considered hate speech when it promotes hatred or violence against groups of people based on protected attributes, such as age, gender, race, disability, religion, sexual orientation, or caste. Hate speech is not allowed on YouTube, and we remove content promoting violence or hatred against individuals or groups based on any of these attributes. Next, our harassment policy. We consider content harassment when it targets an individual with prolonged or malicious insults based on intrinsic attributes, such as their membership to a protected group, status as a survivor of sexual assault, or physical traits. This also includes harmful behavior such as threats, blackmail, bullying, publishing someone's private or identifying information, or encouraging abusive fan behavior against a specific individual, which you may know as brigading. Content used to harass others is not allowed on YouTube. Now that you know about our policies, let's dive into some of the tools available to protect you. We'll walk through two options. First, you can report things that violate our policies. And second, you can moderate comments on your own channel, even if they don't necessarily violate our policies. Let's first dive into how you can report inappropriate or abusive content that violates our policies. To report a video, click the three-dot menu on desktop or mobile and select Report. You'll be prompted to select the reason that best fits the violation in the video, and you can provide any additional details that may help the review team make their decision, including timestamps or descriptions of the violation. You can also report comments, thumbnails, and playlists with the same process. Just always look out for the three-dot menu and select Report. Note that reporting content for hate and harassment violations is anonymous, so other users won't be able to tell who made the report. If you want to report an entire channel due to impersonation or inappropriate use of their channel banner or profile picture, go to the channel page you want to report, click About, and then Report. Note that when something's reported, it's not automatically taken down. YouTube staff reviews reported content 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Reported content is reviewed against our community guidelines and is checked for age appropriateness. If no violations are found by our review team, no amount of reporting will change that, and the content will remain on our site. If you have a privacy concern about content where someone uses your personal, uniquely identifiable information, please visit our Help Center where you can use our privacy complaint process. Next, let's walk through tools to help you moderate comments if you see any that are harassing or abusive. First, you can choose to remove a comment posted on your own channel. You can do this in YouTube Studio from the Publish tab or from the Watch page under Videos by clicking the three-dot menu on desktop or mobile and selecting Remove. The commenter will not know that you've removed their comment. If someone is being consistently inappropriate in your comments, you can hide them from your channel. Hiding a commenter will hide all of their past and future comments on your videos. All of their previous comments should be hidden within 48 hours. The user will not know that you've hidden them, and nothing will look different on their end if they try to post new comments on your videos. There are two options you can use to hide a commenter: from one of their existing comments or from YouTube Studio. If you find a comment that they've left on your channel or video, you can select the three-dot menu and then Hide User from Channel. Or to hide them from YouTube Studio, you can copy the user's channel URL, then go to YouTube Studio, then Settings, then Community. In the Hidden Users box, paste their channel URL, and then click Save. And finally, what tools can you use to protect your entire comment section from inappropriate or abusive behavior? You can create a blocked words list. Sometimes people may use words or phrases that you don't want associated with your channel. In YouTube Studio, go to Settings and then Community. Here you'll see a section for blocked words. In this section, you can add words or phrases that you don't want to appear in your comment section. When someone tries to comment using these blocked words, they won't appear publicly and can be found in the Held for Review tab. Some creators choose to ignore this tab entirely so they don't have to see these comments. The commenter won't know that their comment has been automatically held for review. Or you can choose to block links, which means new comments with hashtags or URLs will automatically be held for review. Finally, you can choose to change your comment settings. You can do so for individual videos, or you can set comment defaults for all of your future uploads. With comment settings, you can choose to allow all comments, hold potentially inappropriate comments for review, hold all comments for review, or disable comments. If you choose to hold comments, they won't appear publicly until you've approved them. Potentially inappropriate comments are held for review on your comments page in YouTube Studio under the Held for Review tab for up to 60 days. Comments that may be especially offensive will be filtered at the bottom of this tab. Remember, you can choose to ignore this tab entirely so you don't have to see these comments. To change this setting for an individual video, go to the Video Details page, then Show More, and then go to the Comments and Ratings section. To set comment defaults for all of your videos moving forward, go to Settings in YouTube Studio, then go to Community, then Defaults. The setting you choose here will apply to comments on all of your new videos. The safety of our creators, viewers, and partners is our highest priority, and we encourage you to use these various tools available to help you. Thank you for helping us protect this unique and vibrant community, and thanks for watching.
C'était vraiment très intéressant.